Ya, rocknya langsung terasa sekali. Anda yang besar di tahun 80-90-an pasti tahu betul dengan nama besar Slash. Salah satu ikon rock dunia yang memberikan inspirasi kepada banyak musisi dari berbagai genre ini masih terus eksis di industri musik. Dan di tengah pandemi, Slash bahkan tetap produktif bersama dengan Miles Kennedy and the Conspirators menggarap album keempat bertajuk Four. Dan untuk membahas hal ini, join with us by Zoom, Slash. Hi, Slash.
Hi.
Hi, good to have you here. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, thank you for asking. Okay, we're speaking about Four. This is the fourth album of you, by you and Miles Kennedy and the Conspirators. And I think it's such an important milestone, right? Like a decade of your work with them as well. So can you tell us about this Four?
About this record? Four is just it's just the latest record that the Conspirators have done. It's a pretty cool rock and roll record. We recorded it live in Nashville last April, but it's finally coming out. Mm-hmm. And you know, and yeah, it's the fourth record that we've done. We've been together for about 11 years now, and it's gone by really quickly. It's pretty amazing that it's been that long, but yeah, it's
okay.
Been good.
More than 10 years, so what does this Four mean to you?
What does it mean? I mean, it just, like I said, it's just the latest record that we've done, but mm-hmm. it's you know, we've arrived at this place and we managed to get this record done during this whole sort of craziness and chaos that's been happening for the last 2 years.
Okay, I was listening to your song, to three songs actually. The River is Rising, Hang On, The River is Rising, and then Call of the Dogs and Fill My Worlds. Actually, how many songs in total will be published in the new album?
There's 10 songs on the record altogether.
10 songs. So which song was the emotional that you make?
All three of those songs were written during the pandemic, so they all have a certain kind of emotional tension to them, mm-hmm, you know. Mm-hmm. But there's a lot of different material on the record, and there's another song on the record called Fall Back to Earth, which is pretty emotional. But it's all pretty high energy. For the most part, it's all very high energy, sort of in-your-face rock and roll music. You know?
I see. But speaking about pandemic, due to global pandemic, you know, was it a difficult record for you guys to make? I mean, I heard you and the band travel across the country to make this happen in the middle of pandemic.
Yeah, well, we recorded the album in Nashville, so we took a tour bus and drove up to Nashville from Las Vegas. Uh-huh. And we took the tour bus. We thought it would be the safest way to travel, you know, across the country. And then we went in the studio and we recorded the record really quickly, you know, like we did it in about 5 days. But cool. Then when we were done recording, Miles caught COVID, and then Brent, and then Todd, and eventually I did. So that was quite the experience. We were all quarantined in Nashville. But uh-huh. When we got better, we came out, we mixed the record, finished it, and drove home. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, so it was quite mm-hmm. the experience.
Okay, what experience. But speaking about Four again, the previous albums were Apocalyptic Love, World on Fire, and Living the Dream. But now it's only Four. Why is it simple like that?
Well, because I think I didn't want to try and come up with a clever or witty title mm-hmm. that was really going to sort of represent what 2020 was. 2020 was just too dramatic, too crazy, and too yeah. hard a year mm-hmm. to be able to come up with a simple title for it. So rather than try to do that, I said, let's just call it Four, because it being a fourth record is quite an accomplishment to have stayed together that long to make four albums. So I figured Four would be a good simple title, you know?
Uh-huh.
And we wouldn't read much into it. You know? And plus I thought it'd be a good reminder that we had three other records for people.
So do you think this album is the best one you've done so far?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you know, I think we have a bunch of good records, obviously, but I think this one is the coolest one we've done so far. But I think every record is a natural evolution, you know, from mm-hmm. one to the next, where you just keep growing as a band. So I think we've arrived at this place, and it's above and beyond where we were on the last one.
Okay, okay. I knew that you'll be on tour in 2022, February 2022, with Miles Kennedy and The Conspirator. How is the preparation until now?
I just got out of rehearsal just now, so we're rehearsing. We start touring in February here in the States, and then hopefully we'll come over, you know, and come to Asia and do all our international stuff. It'll be at the beginning of 2023.
Yeah, we hope that. But how do you see live performance nowadays? Because, you know, it might feel a little different since COVID.
Yeah. I toured with Guns N' Roses a couple of months ago, you know, in the States as well. Mm-hmm. But got my first sort of taste of what it's like to be touring during COVID. So there's a lot of precautions taken. There's a lot of restrictions and sort of rules, you know, that you have to abide by in order to be out there mm-hmm. Touring and to stay safe. But you know, so this next tour is going to be pretty much the same. But the time that you actually spend on stage in front of a crowd, that's the one time that you really don't have to worry too much about anything. Mm-hmm. You know, it's really just about the show and it's about the audience. And it's pretty explosive because of the fact that there's been so many, you know, lockdowns and restrictions over the last couple of years that people are really anxious to be able to get out and have a good time. So, and the same for us as a band, we're just anxious to get out and actually play in front of people. So that part of it is really exciting. The rest of it is twice as much work as it used to be, you know?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, yeah. Okay, but you've been active in the music industry since 80s and spending the last decade with Miles Kennedy and The Conspirator. We want to know, what are the secrets to keep everyone in the band having the same idea, the same voices?
There's no secret to that. I think, like in this particular band, everybody just wants to play.
Mm-hmm.
It's a really simple, easy band, you know? everybody just wants to put together, I mean, we have a lot of the same musical influences and the same sort of musical goals, I guess. And so we just want to get together and make some great music and put out the record and go out and tour. And that's all anybody in the band wants to do. So it's not real complicated, you know?
Not complicated. Okay. Last question. What advice do you have to the younger musician or to Indonesian musicians so, you know, they can adapt to this music industry for a long time like you did?
I don't know. The music industry has changed so much since I got into it. It's hard to sort of give anybody any kind of real advice because I'm still trying to learn how to navigate the sort of new terrain. But I think the most important thing is to stick to the music that you really love. Don't let anybody try and tell you different. And then go out and try and figure out how you can connect with an audience and, mm-hmm. and the best way to make that possible. And you know, do what you have to do and be prepared to work really, really hard and to sacrifice everything in order to do what you love to do.
Even though the music industry has a lot of change, but I don't know, I can see you, your power, your skill, how you got the melody on your songs. It's like, oh, you're still you and still wow.
Well, I just do what I do, and I've been doing, you know, my kind of thing ever since I started, and I've never really been part of what sort of you would consider the mainstream music industry, you know? I've always sort of been on the sort of sidelines or on the fringes of it, but I'm happy that way, you mm-hmm. know? I like to be able to do what it is that I want to do, and I don't want to have anybody trying to dictate to me that I should do it differently.
Okay, anyway, do you have the exact plan to visit Indonesia? I mean, you do have huge fans in here, and I believe they miss your performance.
I would love to come back there, and so I'm hoping that we'll be able to come back next year. We've had some great shows over there. So yeah, I've got my fingers crossed that we're going to be coming up there next year.
Yeah, we're waiting.
So you have to put a good word in for us.
We're waiting for come back. Okay, Slash, thank you so much for your time. Keep inspire us, okay? Be happy, be healthy. Oh. Thank you so much.
All right, no, it was great talking to you. Thank you, and hopefully see you soon.
You rock, man. See you soon. Bye-bye. So that's it, my interview with Slash. Ladies and gentlemen, 4 by Slash featuring Miles Kennedy and The Conspirator will be released February 11, 2022. Dan, itu dia tadi Showbiz Corner pekan ini. Tetaplah bersama kami di CNN Indonesia Connected.